Welcome to our midweek edition of Upon Further Review. I'm Josh Aubrey. Plenty to get to in this week's show. The Georgia Southern Eagles trying to turn around quickly from their loss to Coastal Carolina. They'll be hosting South Alabama Thursday night at Paulson Stadium. We'll hear from Coach and some of the players coming up. As for our area high school football teams, you've got the Statesboro Blue Devils back home. A big drop in competition after playing Richmond Hill and Brunswick back-to-back. They play Bradwell. Bradwell has struggled so far this year. The Blue Devils hosting them at Womack Field. As for the Bulk Academy Gators, coming off a breeze of a victory on the road at Trinity Christian, they should have their hands full coming up Friday night as they'll be hosting Frederica. We'll also send you out for highlights from Southeast Bullock softball Elite Eight matchup with Rockmart at home. Couple games there. We'll send you out for those and plenty much more coming up on Upon Further Review. And a reminder before we go to break, hopefully you'll never be in an accident, but if so, please give our friends at the Sullivan Law Firm a call, 912-489-8888, or online at thesullivanlawfirm.com.
The Medical Center Pharmacy on Grenade Street is proud to be your Health Mart Pharmacy in Statesboro. The Medical Center Pharmacy, locally owned and serving this community for 50 years, is open 364 days a year. The pharmacists at Medical Center know there's nothing more important than your family's well-being. That's why they take the time to know their customers, explain their medications, and answer any questions. The Medical Center Pharmacy, your Health Mart Pharmacy. Health Mart, caring for you and about you.
Well, the Georgia Southern Eagles not having much time to lick their wounds from their loss 28-14 on the road at then 24-ranked Coastal Carolina. This Thursday, they return to action at Paulson Stadium as they'll be hosting South Alabama at 7:30. We had a chance to talk with Coach Lunsford and some of the players about how they feel about trying to bounce back this week.
It was definitely a tough one, but, you know, right now we got to put it in the past and move on forward, and let's focus on getting the next win coming up. Stopping the run and stuff like that, that's not the exception. That's the expectation around here. And it's just the little things that we have to fine-tune to take our game from good to great. And this week we want to focus on fine-tuning those little things and not letting mistakes beat us that can cost us in the long run. So this week, like I said, we want to fine-tune the little things and make sure we don't let little mistakes bite us. Like, every week is a – We take the opponent as just another week to prepare and go out there for a win. So, you know, like I said, what happened Saturday happened, and now it's time to move on forward and get ready for South Al and come out victorious.
You know, we didn't play Georgia Southern football on the offense how we normally want to. You know, I think it comes down to us being disciplined and detailed in our game. And, you know, that starts with me at center. You know, every play starts with me snapping the football, and there was two times where I couldn't get that done and had two snap infractions on me with false starts. So it really comes down to me, you know, me at center and on the offensive line being more detailed with how we're operating, executing, giving Shy and our running backs more area work. And then just being, you know, more disciplined in our game overall, I think, is the big focus that we're working on this week. You know, I think there's less time for us to really look at that film and see what we need to get handled. But yesterday we did, you know, we went through it as an offense together and really made sure the picture was clear for all of us to see the details where we all need to improve as an offense together. And so I think that part, and then now, you know, going into Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday here, game Thursday, I think that's really an advantage, is just for us to move on and understand what we need to get better at quickly here.
You know, first and foremost, I don't ever want to take anything away from our opponent. I thought Coastal had a really good game plan, and I thought they executed very, very well against our offense. They controlled the line of scrimmage. They were able to get extra hats to the ball and extra hats to our plays. The other piece to it, you know, I just didn't see the same energy and fire that we had been coming out with. You know, I know I was asked, I believe I was asked by you, you know, talking about coming out flat. I don't know. I don't know if we came out flat. I just think the initial part of it, of not executing right off the start, you know, really kind of stuck with our guys, and we just didn't get anything going. And, you know, really to only have, you know, a couple drives in that game, one where, we score off an interception. We were able to drive and score a touchdown. And then we had a drive and we missed a field goal. And that was really all we did on offense. I think we do have good players. I do feel like that we should be a better offense. I think the inconsistency piece is a problem. I believe that if we could be more consistent, and you know, again, we had a bad game. And I, you know, I'm not going to step away from that. And again, you know, if we're looking at offensively, you know, through the first five games, you know, you can look at other teams' records and you could say, well, we should perform better against these teams. And then you can look at the ones that are have good, really good records and are ranked. You know, how did we perform against them? And I think that's what you've got to make sure that you don't do is sit there and look at it and go, well, because you did this against this team, you're where you need to be. And I think it's important that we challenge our staff and we challenge our guys to get better each and every day. And but I do feel like we have the talent. I mean, I think we've got good skill at the running back position. I think we have gotten better at the wide receiver position for sure in recruiting. You know, I think Shy's continuing to show that he's growing and that, you know, a four-year starting quarterback that can come run our offense and basically be a coach on the field for us. And, you know, we got experience at offensive line, you know, and our guys, you know they didn't play well Saturday. And, you know, hopefully they come out with a chip on their shoulder tonight and go to work and then be ready to play on Thursday night. I think it's the physicality and the effort. Like, if you go back and watch that Southern Miss film, and I remember watching the game early on because we didn't have a game that week. And I remember watching it and just going, wow, man, you know, South Alabama's playing fast and they're playing with a lot of effort and talent-wise look to be better. And, you know, hadn't studied them until now, but I think that's what's happening. You know, these last two games, being able to get those two wins in a row, you know, they're showing what they show when they open the season. So I think the ability to really be hone in on what they do on offense and defense, but the physicality, the effort they play with, and then the talent that they're getting in there, I think has really shown this year.
All right, stay with us. Coming up next, we'll hear from some high school football coaches for their matchups coming up this week.
My Queensboro banker is Cheryl Quick.
Blanchard Equipment Company has 16 locations.
Queensboro has homegrown values just like us.
They get heavily involved in every community.
And that means strong customer service.
They've been around a long time, just like John Deere.
When you run across a bank like that, you stick with them.
I sure would like to own one of these John Deeres.
Well, we can sure make that happen.
Oh, well.
Queensboro is your community bank. Queensboro National Bank and Trust.
The folks at the Georgia Southern University store want all Eagle fans to know the Statesboro campus of the university store will be open Saturday, September 12th from 11 a.m. until 3:30 p.m. and Saturday, September 19th from 11 a.m. until 4 p.m. Both Paulson Stadium stores will be open for window and counter service with a selection of Georgia Southern apparel from the time the gates open until the end of halftime. Web orders from the full selection of Georgia Southern apparel, hats, gifts, and tailgating items may be ordered for free pickup at Paulson Stadium at the home side store during game day hours. Web orders must be placed by 1 p.m. on Friday for each of the first two home games. So don't forget, for all your game day and Georgia Southern needs, shop the University Store on the Georgia Southern campus. Well, Statesboro Blue Devils looking to rebound from their couple losses. After their victory over Liberty County, they went up to Richmond Hill, got beat pretty bad, then turned around and went down to Glenn County Stadium, taking on Brunswick, and were right in that game into the fourth quarter, and then the wheels fell off of that one. This week, They get to play the Bradwell Institute Tigers coming up Friday night at Walnut Field. We had a chance to talk with Coach Kaiser and a few players about the matchup.
Credit to Brunswick, very good football team. Proud of our kids, their effort, like we have been all year. You know, we're actually in the process of showing our guys right now just how close we are. And little things, you know, a while ago we talked about accountability and trust. You know, we got to be able to depend on you to do it the right way. But, you know, fortunately, this is a situation, a game where we can learn from it and put it behind us. And, you know, it seems like we've been saying that a lot the last couple of weeks, but we got to move on. I don't sense any of our kids quitting, you know, or getting that down. So we approach it business-like every week, and we'll make the adjustments necessary and move forward. Our backs are playing well. Our inexperience up front, offensively, we've got two guys that should be playing JV in the 10th grade. We got one starter up front who's until this year has never played a down of football. I'm not making an excuse because those guys have gotten better and they'll be coached up and continue to get better. We just got to keep pushing forward, and we're getting better each game. But we're playing some stud defenses right now too. So we control what we control, and our kids get better. That's all we can ask them to do. We got to move on and get ready for Brabble. Brabble's probably the most improved football team that I've seen in a long time, from their first game to their third. Look a lot like Brunswick, big on their lines of scrimmage, athletic on the perimeter. So, you know, there are no weeks off for us. We know that. We just come back to work and put our nose down and make some adjustments and get better. That's all we can do. Big up front, very multiple offensively, formation-wise, a lot of motion to try to get you out of position. Very well coached on the offensive side of the ball. Play hard defensively. Seems to be they're a lot like Richmond Hill and Brunswick from a on the hoof standpoint, what they look like. Got team speed, quarterback's a runner, so we'll have to. This is definitely not a week where we can take a deep breath and say, oh, well, we should get this one. You know, it's going to be a challenge every week for us.
Right now, I feel like we could have finished a little stronger this week. This week, we have to, like, practice, stay focused a little bit more, and got to get our more win, you know, so it can last longer. We wasn't as physical in the second half. We wasn't as physical in the second half. I feel like if we would have been more physical, we would have put up a better fight in the second half. I feel like I'm getting the hang of it now. I feel like we coming together. We change little offense a little bit, running the power. I feel like I get more yards off of that. Yeah, I feel like we get this. I feel like we're gonna go 4-0 now. I feel like these next couple of games we can go pull it out.
I feel like where we are right now is just improving and getting better from the past games that we done played. And just improving. As a team, we know what we got and what we can do, and we just got to keep playing. We just got to stay more physical and be disciplined and execute and finish in the fourth quarter, little things like that. We need this game a lot because it's a region game, coming in to win, homecoming, so yeah, really need to execute.
Our Southeast Bullock segment is brought to you by Scott's Floor Covering, passionate to floor you for all your installation needs with over 30 years of experience. Please call Joel Scott at 912-536-2107 or email scottsfloorcovering@yahoo.com for a free quote today. This segment is brought to you in part thanks to After Hours Glass Service, LLC, where they truly believe that if you don't take care of a customer, somebody else will. Wishing much success for the Yellow Jackets 2020 season.
It's one of them things that it kind of worked out. We had a game last week. It got canceled by the other team. But, you know, we're doing the best we can. It was actually our fall break. Our kids were out all week. So we did it. We practiced on Monday and Tuesday that week and gave our kids off the rest of the week to just kind of heal up and spend time with families and things like that, or go on vacations or anything that they need to. But we're back this week. We don't have a game schedule. We're trying to find something, you know, in the works, possibly up until tomorrow, where we'd have enough time to prepare if needed. But we, as of right now, we have 2 weeks off. I spent about probably 6 or 7 hours on Saturday and Sunday, and then kind of through Friday, just spread out between looking up teams that needed games by contacting GHSA, and they provided a list of who needs games on what dates, and just trying to reach out to teams or, you know, and, you know, getting them to come here. Some didn't want to travel, some didn't want to play, or some were unavailable or already filled. So we're trying to kind of go through that list and figure out what we can, because we're down to 8 games right now, and we're trying to at least have 9 for the kids. Just to get better in all phases of the game. I mean, we've accomplished that first goal of what we were trying to do. Now we're just trying to use these next 2 or 3 games that we have left to be able to improve just in what we're trying to do. And we've got some good opponents. We've got at least 2 6A opponents we'll play in Evans and Lakeside. That'll be a good test for us. So we're just trying to improve and make sure we're clicking on all cylinders by the time we get to that playoff game.
It felt good to win the region championship after not doing it for a whole lot of years. But and whenever they told us we can't, whenever the games got canceled and we might be off for a couple more weeks, I mean, just chance to just recover and I guess come out and play next time we play. It's kind of upsetting, but I mean, that's how it's going to be throughout the season. I mean, our guys always ready to play, and I mean, it kind of just hurt.
Having won the region championship, you know you're the number one seed. You still have a few games left. What's the mindset like? I mean, it'd be easy to kind of say, all right, we can just kind of cruise now.
Can't do that, because if we do that, we're going to come out flat. And if the game's getting harder and harder, if we come out flat, it's not going to be a good game. We're trying to win the championship.
Friday night lights to early morning deer stands, Anderson's General Store in Statesboro is your tailgating and hunting headquarters. Boots from Ariat, Georgia Boot, Irish Setter, Wolverine, and more, we have a pair for you. Check out our Costa and Ray-Ban sunglasses. And apparel from Columbia, Carhartt, and Drake. Dove, ducks, deer, we have all your hunting needs. And tailgate with a Big Green Egg or Traeger grill. Pack in the flavor with delicious sauces and rubs. Anderson's General Store, a general store and so much more.
Ready for fall? Us too at RJ Pogue. Get ready to cheer on your favorite team in a new performance polo from Peter Millar, Southern Tide, and AFCO. Ladies, we have the best brands and trending fashions. Complete your look with one of our best-selling shoe brands, Soft, On Cloud, and Free People. Shop these brands and so much more at one of our 3 locations, RJ Pope Buckhead, Downtown, and Vidalia.
Well, the Bullock Academy Gators coming off a pretty easy victory this past week against Trinity. In fact, the last couple weeks, the Gators have not had much competition. That will all change this Friday as they'll be hosting Frederica. We had a chance to talk with Coach Pennington and a few of the players about the game.
We're playing with a lot of confidence and showing signs of improvement day by day, and certainly it shows up on Friday night. The last 2 weeks we've made a lot of progress, considering we had a month off before we played. And I think our players are in the mindset that to continue to move up the board a little bit more each week and try to even correct the things that we still are doing, some of our weaknesses that have hampered us over the course of the season. And there's a pretty good attitude from the standpoint that we want to get better. But right now I think we are playing with a lot of confidence, which we certainly need going into this week.
You've got Frederica coming up Friday, a very good team coming to your place. Could possibly be for the region championship between you, them, and Pinewood. Your thoughts on the game?
Well, from what I've seen on Frederica, they're a solid football team. And not only that, they've played some pretty stiff competition along the way. I think their record may be 4-2, but if you look at who they play, even in defeat, they were very competitive. And so I think that has certainly propelled them to go into this season with a lot of confidence. And I'm sure they'll come to Bullock Academy with some confidence next week as well. You know, being new here, Josh, it's my understanding this is a pretty intense rivalry, if you can say that, even though they're way down in St. Simon's. Apparently there's some kind of history that goes on between these two schools. So I know that they're going to be ready to play. They have a vision of, and I think a large senior class as well, and have a vision as far as going to winning a region championship. And so do we. So it should have the makings of a good football game, competitive football game. Definitely they're well coached. From what we have seen, they operate like a well-oiled machine. And so in that regard, with all the motions, it's important that we stay focused. It is homecoming week. We got to stay focused on the task at hand, not be distracted by other things, and at the same time try to get better in what we're doing fundamentals and with our techniques and our execution of our schemes, and we'll be okay.
We're playing together, sticking together as a team, and we're just executing really well, and as long as we do that, we should be okay.
The offense for the last three games, I guess, has really put up a lot of points. Coach said you guys did some things to kind of make things a little simpler. Can you explain a little bit about that?
Just where everybody understands and can, it's not complicated, so we can just, you know, just drive the ball well, and we're executing real well. And
I mean, as Coach said, we definitely have a confidence boost. We've been practicing more and more and focusing on the little things bigger than other things we've been doing. And our playbook, we've been shortening plays up on offense. Definitely the blocking. We've been focusing a lot on our line, and so that's allowed our running backs to get good yardage every run.
You got Frederica coming up. It could be one of the games that between you, them, and Pinewood for the region championship. Pretty big game. It's homecoming week. How are you guys feeling about it?
We know they lost against Tifteria, but we shouldn't change our mentality about that. We need to keep a focused mind, worry about executing our positions right, and we just need to be focusing on them instead of anything else.
Stay with us. Up next, we'll head over to Brooklet to see how the Southeast Bullock Yellow Jacket softball team did in the Elite Eight as they were hosting Rockmart. Family Internal Medicine Associates of Statesboro, providing primary care for Statesboro area patients since 1998, providing complete physicals, complete sports physicals, Medicare wellness exams, full diabetes treatment, and education from lifestyle changes to oral medications to insulin pump therapy, in-house dermatology, in-house circulation tests, and ultrasounds, and in-house labs. Featuring nurse practitioner Melissa Beasley, Family Internal Medicine of Statesboro can accommodate same-day or next-day appointments to serve your needs. Family Internal Medicine and Associates of Statesboro, where we care.
Credit refused isn't just an offer, it's a way of business, and has been for over 100 years. No banks, no ridiculous credit requirements, just local Badcock store owners who treat you right and give you credit when others won't. It's never been easier to express your style and love your home.
Well, the Southeast Bullock Yellow Jackets were taken to three games in the opening round of the state softball tournament against Jackson, had to end up winning the third and decisive game in that one. Then in round two, they were able to sweep Appling in one day, winning 2 1-run games, 1-0 in the first, 5-4 in the second. Here on this past Tuesday, they were hosting Rockmart. Let's see how things went. A battle of the Yellow Jackets in Brooklet. Southeast Bullock hosting Rockmart in the state quarterfinals. Southeast Bullock starts the scoring. Megan Lee doubles to the fence and left, 2-run score, and it's 2-0 Southeast Bullock. In the fourth, Elena Barnard, the RBI single to left to make it 5-1. Rockmart able to come back to make it 5-3 on the RBI single to right by Gracie Arnold. But with the bases loaded, Barnard able to get back-to-back fly balls to end the inning. Southeast able to tack on some insurance runs. Barnard, the RBI triple. It'll fall into right field. Brings home Kelsey McDuffie. And then it's McKinley Fields with the two-run double into left. Barnard ends up with 7 strikeouts in the game, allowing just 5 hits. Southeast wins game 1, 8-3. A little tougher time in the nightcap. Barnard would throw another good game on the mound, but not get much run support. Should help her own cause here. With 2 on, the RBI single into right. But with the bases loaded, Southeast could not get any more runs. Check out the play here by pitcher Emily Register. Nice way to protect herself. Rockmart able to get a fielder's choice to tie the game as Maddie Owens plates Briley King to make it 1-1. Later, it's Sam Wolf with the RBI single. Coming up right here into right field. That proves to be the game winner. Rockmart takes game 2, 2-1, forcing a game 3 on Wednesday. Battle of the Yellow Jackets is Southeast Bullock and Rockmart in the 3rd and decisive game with a trip to the Final 4 on the line. Elena Barnard on the mound looking solid here. The strikeout to end the inning. Later, she's going to get some help as Shyla Thames makes the throw from her knees for the out at first. The Jackets looking to start the scoring. In the 3rd, Olivia Horton the single into left to start things off. Jaden Sherrod then with the bunt. It gets through. Next up, Kelsey McDuffie. She puts down a great bunt, beats the throw, but is ruled out for the bat hitting the ball when she dropped it. A tough call, and the Jackets unable to bring in the runners. Top of the 4th, and the game is scoreless no more. Megan Johnson, the solo shot to center, and Rockmart will grab a 1-0 lead. The Southeast Bullock Yellow Jackets trying to answer, 1-1, and McKinley Fields drive to right center, caught by a diving Alex Teams. We move ahead to the 5th, and with the bases loaded, Sam Wolf, the deep drive to right. Gracie Bergen comes up throwing, but Annalie Morris hustles home from 3rd. Rockmart adds 2 more to go up 4-0. Later, 5-0 in the bottom of the 6th. Megan Lee, the shot to 3rd. This would load the bases. The infield in, and Bergen with the RBI, but the Jackets only score 2 runs, and then in the 7th, this would prove to be the final out of the game as Southeast Bullock's season ends 5-2 the final. And that'll wrap it up for this week's show. We thank you for joining us. Hope to see you again next week.